I came home from prison in 2005, and what I found is that almost to the man or the woman, every single person I knew wanted to hear as much about the experience as I was willing to tell. And so I eventually decided that I would try to write a book.
A friend of mine who knew Piper sent me the book and said, you have to read this. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. And then I begged Lionsgate to get it for me. And then I had to convince Piper to trust me with it. And she did. I'm grateful.
Her enthusiasm for the book and for the material and for the setting was so apparent. And her curiosity was voracious. I was really, really excited that she decided that it was something she wanted to bring to the screen.
When I read the book, I loved the characters. There were so many stories to tell. There were characters who I don't think you could sell a series on, but Piper was the perfect entree into this world. You could take this yuppie white girl and follow her in, and through her, as like a gateway drug, you can tell all these other stories as well.
Hi, I'm Chapman. Yeah, that's me. I heard you might have something that I need.
J. Cruz is around the corner.
I'm really a big fan of Genji's work. I think the stuff she did on Weeds was pretty extraordinary. And I really also like the idea that it was a woman's story, not in relationship to how she's reacting to being kind of pushed around by a guy. This is really like the heroine's journey. It's Piper going out and dealing with the consequences of her own actions and kind of coming into who she really is in prison.
I am in here because I am no different from anybody else in here. I made bad choices. I committed a crime. And being in here is no one's fault but my own.
One of the fundamental questions for me is, you know, are you the choices you made in the past or the choices you've decided to live by? Piper was this wild child in her early 20s, and those adventures fed her and were exciting for her. And then she decided to be a grown-up and settle down and have this fairly conventional, safe life. And now she's in this situation where the skills and the impulses of those early years might help her survive better. And it gets very confusing. Is she that early girl, or is she the mature woman she was becoming? And does she need to focus on the microcosm of the prison to survive, or does she need to focus on the macro of the life she's created and wants to re-inhabit when she gets out? And I think it all gets swirled around for her, and I think that's an interesting thing to look at.
There's a lot of strain on their relationship, and their commitment is definitely tested. Questions arise about their commitment to each other. How committed are they? How committed can they be? And how committed should they be to each other?
You know, the cool thing about the show is, like, even though we're in prison, it's really just about these relationships and how these women get put in this situation and they have to figure out how to survive, you know? And I think a lot of us can relate to that in different ways. You know, the world that we've created is so real and authentic that you really get the sense of what these women went through.
You seem sweet. But there's rules in this place. The most important of which is, the second you're perceived as weak, you already are.
To be in this kind of an almost all-female ensemble is a great gift, particularly at this stage in my life and in my career. I'm watching these mostly younger women come up, and they're delightful. They're so eager to risk and try and go deep. Genji's been so careful about making this true, authentic. They're all deeply authentic.
I had grand plans. Now I can't even get past this swirling darkness in my brain long enough to land on anything.
Survival is sort of based on relationships. You can't survive on your own in prison. You have to be connected to people. You have to be connected in the right ways to people. And that's why I think it's such a fascinating place for dramatic purposes, because you can't be an island in prison. You cannot survive on your own. You have got to have alliances, and you've got to have alliances with the right people and not the wrong people. So it's driven by relationship.
It'll be okay, sister.
There's always hope tomorrow will be taco night.
Tomorrow's beef and noodles.
Or beef and noodles.
It's not a dark, ominous women in prison thing. I think humor is a survival technique. And I think if you just did a straight drama about prison, it would become so oppressive. It would become oppressive to write.
What happens behind prison walls is hidden from the public very intentionally. And so I wanted to show it in my book, and I think that that is what Genji is striving to show in the show, is those day-to-day relationships and interactions that create the world of this institution and the people who live there and who work there.
That's what I hope that people kind of find in this show, that they see these characters that are huge and different and maybe far removed from where they are in their own lives, and in those characters see their mom and their best friend and their sister and their daughters.
I'm proud to turn on the TV and see 100 different women on the screen of every age and every color and every race. I have not seen that before. And to be able to tell all their stories is a privilege and something that I've been surprised hasn't been out there before. And I feel really proud of that.